When you're first learning induction, this is one of the most famous examples to do. Because if you do it right, it turns out fairly nicely. Your homework problem is going to be a little harder than this, a little trickier. So it's something to still work on. You have the structure still the same in either case. You have a base case. In this case, we're trying to show, I should emphasize something else here. We're trying to prove that this equation is true for all natural numbers n. That's important. This funny looking n could be thought of as being the natural numbers. You could also think of it as positive integers. I could write z plus for positive integers. The base case then means start with n equal to 1. Is this equality true when n equals 1? Yes, because it's trivial. 1 does in fact equal 1 times 1 plus 1 over 2 because that's 2 over 2. Therefore, the base case is proved. The base case almost always is pretty easy. There are a few examples here and there where the base case is not easy to prove, but most examples you encounter and will encounter, it is easy. The next thing is the inductive, you could call it inductive step or inductive hypothesis. I probably prefer calling it inductive hypothesis. But if you call it inductive step, that's fine. It is important to say either assume or suppose here at the start. Assume that this equation is true for some positive integer. What should we call the integer? Should we call it n? Should we call it k? It doesn't really matter. Maybe it's better to use a different letter. Since I'm trying to show this is true for all positive n, maybe let's go ahead and assume it's true when n gets replaced by k, where k is some positive integer. To me, it's important to say the words for some positive integer here as well. Some natural number. Say assume or suppose, and then say for some. This is an assumption we're making as part of the inductive proof, and it's different than what we're trying to prove, because we're trying to prove the equation is true for all, emphasis on the for all positive integers. In the assumption here, you're just assuming it's true for some. And then you know that you need to prove it's also true when k gets replaced by k plus 1. That's the way induction goes. You could write, we must show it's true when k is replaced by k plus 1, but let's just go ahead and do it. Then 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dot, 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 plus, okay. For extra emphasis, I'll put the k in there before I put the k plus 1. You got to use, when you do the inductive step here, this final part, you got to use your inductive hypothesis. Have to. Otherwise, you're not doing induction. If you don't use your inductive hypothesis in some way, you're not doing induction. That's, besides the base case, that's the whole point. So I've got to use this fact right here. Fortunately, in this case, it's easy to use, because it represents the sum of the first k of those. So I can go ahead and use that assumption. It equals k plus 1 over 2 by the inductive hypothesis. What am I trying to show this equals? I'm trying to show it equals essentially the right-hand side when k gets replaced by k plus 1. So really k plus 1 times k plus 2 all over 2. It's not clear that it does. You got to do some work besides using that inductive hypothesis, but the work is fairly easy in this case. Get a common denominator of 2 like this. I also expanded the top there. You've got a common denominator. You can add the fractions. by adding their numerators. And then fortunately, it works out nice. You can factor this as k plus 1 times k plus 2, like I just said, all over 2. For extra emphasis, you could write k plus 1 times, in parentheses, k plus 1 plus 1, all over 2, showing that it's got the right form. It does look like the right-hand side there when k gets replaced by k plus 1. I wouldn't care if you showed that last step there or not. We're not quite done. Final thing you should say is, therefore, by the principle of mathematical induction, what can we conclude? We can conclude what we wanted to conclude, that the equation 1 plus 2 plus 3 through dot, dot, dot plus n equals n times n plus 1 over 2 for all positive integers n. Again, also called natural numbers. Emphasis once again on the for all. We're done. Praise the Lord. 10 class, funny 30-second story. One of the most famous mathematicians ever was named Gauss. And the story is Gauss was so smart that when Gauss was in kindergarten, well, the rest of the class was behaving, not Gauss himself. So the teacher said, okay, everybody get your slates out. This was 200 years ago. And add up the first 100 numbers. Gauss thought about it for 1 second, wrote it down. The answer was right. What did Gauss do in his head in 1 second? Add up the first 100 numbers. What is the answer? He essentially derived this formula in his head in 1 second. That's the story, at least. How? Not by doing induction. By calling the sum S and then rewriting the sum in the opposite order, then adding those two equations and noticing that everything over there, when you add vertically, gives you 101. And how many 101s are there? There are 100 of them. So S is 100 times 101 over 2. Hey, that fits this. He derived that in his head in about 1 second. So that's 10,100 over 2, and the answer is 5,050. Fun, fun, fun. Oops. Fun story about Gauss. Okay, genius mathematician. He didn't do induction. Have a good day.